Listening Library presents Who is Gloria Steinem? By Sarah Fabini. Read for you by Sunila Nankani. Who is Gloria Steinem? On June 4th, 1982, over 1,000 people attended a birthday party at the Park Avenue Armory in New York City. The birthday party wasn't for a person. It was for Ms. Magazine. The magazine was celebrating its 10th birthday. But the partygoers weren't just there to celebrate Ms. They were there to honor the women who had started it, especially one woman in particular, Gloria Steinem. Gloria was the force behind the magazine. She had become the face of women's rights in the United States. When the magazine started, Gloria claimed she would only be there for 2 years. She wasn't sure she wanted to be involved longer than that. And she wasn't sure the magazine would last much longer than that either. But after 10 years, both Gloria and Ms. were going as strong as ever. At the party, Gloria made a speech reminding the partygoers how far women had come since the magazine started. Women were no longer just housewives and mothers. They were astronauts, doctors, police officers, and even U.S. Supreme Court justices. The anniversary of Ms. was a proud moment for Gloria Steinem. She'd had a difficult childhood, yet Gloria was determined to improve her life, and she did. And she used that same determination to help improve the lives of millions of women around the world. Chapter 1. A Wandering Family. Gloria Marie Steinem was born in Toledo, Ohio, on March 25, 1934. Her parents, Leo Steinem and Ruth Nunviller, had met at the University of Toledo in 1917. They both worked on the college newspaper. After college, they married. Ruth taught college math for a year. It wasn't the career she really wanted, but she had promised her mother that she'd try teaching. After a year, Ruth quit and got a job doing what she wanted to do. She became a reporter for the Toledo Blade. At that time, people didn't think a woman could be as good of a reporter as a man. So Ruth used a man's name, Duncan McKenzie, for her work at the newspaper. Ruth loved being a journalist, but she took a year off when their daughter Suzanne was born in 1925. Leo worked odd jobs after college. The year that Suzanne was born, he bought some land in Clark Lake, Michigan. Clark Lake was a rural area about 50 miles northwest of Toledo. Leo built a resort in 1928. It was called Ocean Beach Pier. Leo hoped big-name bands would come and play for all the guests, but Leo's timing was bad. The Great Depression hit in 1929, and many people lost their jobs. They weren't able to spend money on things like weekends dancing at a lake resort. In 1930, to help save money, the Steinems sold their house in Toledo and moved to Clark Lake. Ruth liked city life, and it was hard to give up her job at the newspaper, but she agreed to make a home at Ocean Beach Pier. Soon after the move, Ruth gave birth to a baby boy who did not live long. That same year, Ruth's father died too. Lonely and isolated in the town of Clark Lake, Ruth had a nervous breakdown. The medication she was prescribed helped, but she slept for hours when she took it. Ruth was no longer able to work or look after her children the way she once did. The Great Depression. The Great Depression began on October 29, 1929, when the stock market crashed, causing many banks and businesses to shut down. It was the worst economic crisis of modern times. Unemployment peaked in 1933, when one quarter of all Americans were out of work.
Sample complete. Ready to continue?